is getting t-shirt weather, ladies and gentlemen. I hate how intense the heat gets in the summertime, but that little period from spring to summer when it's just real perfect, you wear a t-shirt without having to sweat completely. We're in that time. We are in that time right now. Let's jump into this video, shall we? It is no secret that a lot of creators are jumping ship from Adobe Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve. It's been a hot topic, actually. A lot of my favorite YouTubers have been making videos about it, talking about moving from it. A couple of the big quirks, if you're not in the whole realm of, you know, video editing softwares and why people are jumping ship, a couple things to keep in mind. Adobe Premiere Pro crashes a lot. Not necessarily to me personally. I've only had it crash a few times, but that's one of the big quirks and the big gripes with using Premiere Pro is that it just crashes a lot. It's very buggy. Another thing is, if you're buying the whole creative suite, you are spending upwards of $600 a year on it. That's a lot of money. $600 a year. It's a lot of money to be spending on your software. Now, of course, that includes things like Photoshop, Illustrator, all that. It's not just the editor. And so you're wondering, okay, so DaVinci Resolve, that must be a pretty penny as well. Well, no, actually not. DaVinci Resolve is completely free. It is a full-fledged video editing software with state-of-the-art, award-winning color grading software and fantastic audio and motion graphic software built into it. All for $0. Just in case you didn't understand, zero means nothing. It doesn't cost you a dime. Literally, it costs you a little bit of hard drive space to download it, but that's it. If you're someone who's wanting to jump ship to DaVinci, and say that you're like me, you have a bunch of presets that you've saved within Premiere, like color grading, LUTs, and things like that, you know, that you've actually created in Premiere, you've saved it as a Premiere Pro preset. If you're like me, you're like, okay, well, I wanna try this new editor, but I don't wanna have to recreate all my looks and again, what do I do? Well, actually, it's actually very, very simple to be able to export your saved Lumetri look as a cube file out of Premiere, and then you can import it into DaVinci Resolve. It's actually pretty banger. I just learned this yesterday. Had no idea that you can actually do this because I'm thinking I do not want to have to recreate all the stuff that I use. I'm so glad I found this solution and I'm here to tell you that solution. Okay. I feel like I'm getting angry for no reason. Okay. We're going to hop into the computer. I'm going to show you how to do it real quick and then let you get off to creating your very delicious banger content within a new editor. So let's do it. So we're gonna open up Premiere Pro. Heading in, here's a project here from the last video that we uploaded called This Audio Hack May Save Your Video. If you haven't watched it yet, I will throw a card up, put it in down below, check it out. So we have the look here. I put all my looks on an adjustment layer, just helps the program to run a little smoothly. What we're gonna do is we're gonna head over to our color panel. Okay, and then up here we see Lumetri color. We're gonna click on this little hamburger menu here. And then we have a couple options right here. We have one that says export as a dot look and one that exports as a dot cube. Traditionally, I have worked with dot cubes before. I think a dot look is just another kind of extension that you can use to throw in. I've never thrown the dot look one into Resolve. I've just used a dot cube. So that's the one we're gonna do. So we're gonna export that. And then you can just throw it wherever you want. Throw it on a desktop, we'll just call it the Studio LUT. Okay, that's done. Okay, so now we're gonna head into DaVinci and we're gonna head over to our color. We're gonna open that up. So you're gonna come over here to LUTs and then just click on any one of these LUTs, right click and select Reveal in Finder. And then what you're gonna do is you wanna create a folder inside this main LUT folder. I have one here already created, CB LUTs Volume 1, TBD. So we're gonna open that up. And then what we're gonna do is we're going to navigate to where we saved our cube file from Premiere and we're gonna dump it into this folder. Okay, so that's dumped in there. So we're gonna X that out. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna come up here. We're gonna right click and hit refresh. And there's CB LUTs Volume 1, perfect. And then our studio LUT, we'll double click on it and bang, that's it. Our look that we created in Premiere Pro, it's now ready for us to use in DaVinci so we can continue our workflow in a completely different editing environment. All right, And that's it, just as simple as that. That should save you guys a lot of time, preventing you from having to recreate that kind of stuff. And we'll see how this trend goes. Maybe in a year or two, it's gonna be a whole new brand new editing machine that might come out, program that might come out that everyone's gonna jump on board with. But for now, the trend looks like it's moving towards DaVinci's completely bonkers, free, robust video editing software. Okay, if you like this video, I appreciate it. Appreciate you guys. And as always, we'll see you in the next one.